OK。
好的，不对，你可以开始。
Om Jnana Timirandasya Jnananjana Shalakaya Chaksur Unmilitam Yena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha Nama Om Vishnu Padaya Krishna Pristaya Bhutale Srimati Bhakti Vedanta Swami Niti Namane Namaste Sarasati Devi Kauravani Pracharine Nirvisesha Shunyavadi Paschachadeshatarine Panchakaupatarubhyascha Kripa Sindhubhai Cha Patitanam Pavanebhyo Vaishnavibhyo Namo Namaha Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityanand Shri Advaita Gadadhar, Shri Vasadi Gaur Bhaktavinda, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. So we're hearing how Jadbharat is explaining to Maharaj Rahugana the nature of material life.
我们您听到的是Jadbharata 给 Maharaj Rahugana 讲到了物质世界的本性。
Maharaj Rahugana was a king, and he was going to visit a holy place, but he had the good fortune to meet Jadbharat.
Rahugana 是一个国王，他准备去拜访这些圣地，由于他的幸运，他遇到了 Jadbharat.
So,Jadbharat revealed himself to be a great devotee, and Maharaj Rahugana took advantage to get transcendental knowledge from him.
Jadbharat 揭示了他超然的这种本性，向他揭示了一些超然的这些知识，而这个 Rahugana 王呢，也向他学习了这些超然的知识。
So when in the beginning, when Jadbharat was explaining.Maharaj Rahugan could not understand what he was meaning, so he asked him to explain it again.
在开始的时候 ,Jadbharat 给这个 Rahugana 王解释的时候 ,Rahugana 王并不能理解，所以他要求 Jadbharat 又一次向他解释了这些事情。
So Jadbharat is again explaining in more detail the nature of the material world.
所以加德巴拉塔就向马哈拉就解又一次解释了物质世界的这些本性，讲述了很多的细节。
So he's telling him how family life is something like being in a blazing fire in the forest.
他解释到这个家庭生活呢，就像在森林里面的熊熊大火一样。
Although people enter into family life.Looking, expecting happiness, they find a lot of difficulty in family life.
很多人进入到家庭生活，他在外在发现有很多的这种快乐，但是呢，他进入到这个家庭生活之后，发现困难重重。
They just simply find more and more unhappiness rather than happiness. It's more and more misery and suffering and.Problems.
与快乐不同的是，他进入到家庭生活，找到的是越来越多的痛苦，越来越多的困惑，越来越多的麻烦。
And there's no chance of ever finding eternal happiness in the family life.
而且在这个家庭生活中，根本找不到永恒的这种快乐。
So in this way, sometimes.The man in the family life will consider himself to be very unfortunate.
所以有些时候，一些男的他在家庭生活中，他会感觉到自己非常的不幸。
And he says he thinks he's suffering like this because he didn't do any pious activities in previous life.
他之所以这么痛苦，是因为他觉得他以前根本没有做什么虔诚活动。
actually the forest fire is no one is responsible for it. It just takes place by nature, by chance.
事实上没有人可以为这种家庭生活而去承担这个责任。它是这个物质世界的这种本性。
But it's just the nature, in the same way, it's the nature of the material world that we experience misery in the material efforts, in the material existence. We find so many problems.
我们在这个物质世界找到了这么多的问题和麻烦，实际上这都是物质世界的这种本性所致。
And because we're very much attached to the bodily conception of life, so it's very difficult for us to get free of the entanglement.
因为我们有这种躯体化的概念，所以我们很难从这种现在的这种情况下解脱出来。
We just suffer.The person in the material life, they just suffer more and more.
在物质世界的这些人，他只是会不断的遭受各种各样的痛苦，越来越多。
And everywhere you find there's the government men who are, they're like meat-eating demons.And sometimes they even eat humans, they eat men also.
有些政府的这些人，他不仅吃肉，他还吃人。
And they come to people in material life to take away all their money, to take away all their wealth.
他在这个物质世界有时候把一些人的所有的钱财抢夺而空。
And so when the man loses all of his money to the government man, then he loses all of his enthusiasm.
当这个人被政府的这个人把钱给都拿走的时候，他觉得他非常的就是什么都没有了，他觉得。
Not enthusiastic, he loses his enthusiasm.
就是他不再有一点点热情，没有热情。
Just like he's lost his own life.
他感觉他自己的生命都失去了。
So, governments, even the people in the government, they also get these problems that people, you know, they're trying to get rich, take the money for the government, but they also have no money themselves, they're also suffering.
即便是政府部门的这些人，他们去拿别人的钱，但是呢，他们自己到头来还是没有钱。
Just like in countries, even like here in India, people have to pay income tax, and the government men, they will come to get their money. The people save the money for a long time.And try to save up a lot of money, and the government men will come, they'll take all the money.
就像在这里的印度，很多人他会去交税，准备一些钱交税。这个时候政府不能，存了很多年去交税。这个时候政府部门的人过来，把他的钱全都拿走了。
The people, they try to keep the money, they try to hide the money, but the government men find it and take it all away.
人们这些老百姓呢，他们想把自己的钱保护好，想把钱藏起来，但是政府还是能把这些钱全部拿走。
So in this way, the poor man in material life becomes very sorry.
所以像在这个物质世界的这些贫穷的人，他们的物质生存非常的悲苦。
And then family attachment is so strong that.When somebody dies, like when the father or the grandfather dies, then the conditioned soul thinks, they think that my grandfather or my father, he's come again. He's come and he's taken birth in our family. He's come again.
在这个物质世界的这些人，他们的家庭生活观念非常强大，对家庭的依附也非常重。当他们的这些，比如说祖父、父亲离开躯体死后，他们还会认为这些亲戚们还会投身到这个家庭里面。
So when he thinks that the grandfather has come again, then they feel so happy that, oh, this is my grandfather, he's taken birth again, he's come back as the son in our family.
当这个亲戚祖父啊，他投身到自己的家庭的时候，他又会觉得，哦，这太幸运了，太好了，我的这个祖父们，他们又投身为我们的孩子。
So this is ignorance of the real nature of life. People are thinking like this because of their attachment.
这就是这个物质世界的愚昧情况，这个源于人们对这个物质世界的生活的依恋。
Yeah. Actually, we come together as a family, just like pieces of straw, which come together.And then they're separated. The wind blows them. They're separated. They never come together again.
事实上，这只是一种幻象，就像在水上的这些浮萍或者浮草，它们有的时候会聚到一起，但是风一吹呢，它们又会消散到各些地方去。
So.This illusion of the family attachment keeps us in the bondage of material life.
这种家庭生活的这种愚昧观念，把我们深深的绑在物质生活之中。
So in family life, people have to perform many different, they have to do yagya, and they're supposed to perform also other different.Things like marriages for the children, and then also then the birth, the thread ceremony for the son.
在这个家庭生活中的这些人，他们有的时候必须得做一些各种祭祀和仪式，比如说孩子的这种婚礼啊等等这些情况。
Yeah, and sometimes they give the sacred thread, Brahmin thread for their children.
有些时候他们还得给这个孩子授予圣献仪式。
And then they have to do also the Shraddha ceremony. This is a ceremony where they offer grains for the departed ancestors.
还有一种叫 Shraddha 仪式，就是为逝去的这些祖先所做的这种祭祀。
So these are all the duties of the Grihastha, and it's a lot of, it costs some money and it's a lot of trouble.To do.
这些都是作为一个居士阶层他的这种责任，他必须做这些职责。
So difficult to get the children married. They have to find a suitable person for the marriage, and then they have to arrange, invite so many of the relatives all to come. They have to spend a lot of money.
这些都是他们的责任，他们必须请亲戚啊，然后为自己的孩子准备嫁妆、婚礼的上的这一切啊，得花去很多很多的钱。
So that's, it's just like going over a big hill. When you go through the forest, sometimes you come to a big hill, you have to cross over the hill. So these material activities are like that, crossing over a big hill.
这就好比一个依附物质活动的人，他不得不翻越崇山峻岭一样。
Because just like when you cross a hill, there will be so many stones and thorns. It will be very painful on the feet, tiring on the legs, so much trouble.
因为在翻山的时候，路上不免有很多的荆棘、小石头，而且翻山的这个过程中也会非常的疲惫。
So this is all part of the material life, all the problems, the troubles which are there in material life.
这些都是物质生活的困难遭受的这种苦难都在那里。
Father is supposed to arrange the marriage of the children, see the children get married.
这个父亲必须承担儿女的这种婚礼，他为必须看着他的儿子结婚啊等等这些事情。
People, they have to, they save up for so many years for the marriage.
他们为这个婚礼得准备很多很多年。
And then sometimes after the marriage, then they get divorced. They don't get along.
嗯，但是呢，这个婚礼没过一段时间就又离婚了，他们并没有持续太长的时间。
So this is it, all the troubles which are there in material life. It's so much suffering.
这些都是物质生活的这种各种麻烦，会有很多的痛苦在这个里面。
It's just like if you fall in a well, if you're in the field, you're walking in the field and you fall in a well. It's very dark, helpless condition. You cannot get out.
就像你在田林里面，你掉到一口黑井里面去，你到达这个黑井，掉到黑井里面，你根本是很无助的一种情况，没有人会救你。
Even you call out, nobody hears you, nobody can hear you, nobody can get you out.
即便你再怎么呼喊，也没有人会帮助你，没有人能把你救出来。
So you can see some ways.It's better for people if they can be brahmachari and accept the austerity and remain in brahmachari life because so many difficulties are there in grihastha life.
所以从某种角度上去说，一个人最好能够一直保持这种 brahmachari， 也就是真守身的这种生活，做一些苦行，然后不必进入到这种 grihastha 居士生活之中，因为居士生活有太多的麻烦。
To maintain grihastha family life, one has to work very hard to get money.
要维系一个居士生活，人必须非常努力的去工作，然后赚取这些钱来维系这个居士生活。
And we know it's not very easy sometimes to get money.
我们知道要赚钱，有些时候真的很不容易。
Then sometimes, because of hunger and thirst, then person becomes very tired, becomes very angry, he gets angry even with his own family, with his own sons and wife and daughter. He will become angry and lose patience with them and say unkind words to them.
有些时候我们也发现，当这个家里的主人，男的，他因为饥渴，因为心里很烦的时候，他失去了耐心，所以呢，对自己的妻子、儿子、女儿，会生气发怒，而且对他们说一些非常不友好的话语。
And sometimes we become a victim of sleep. A sleep is just like a big python, a big snake, which swallows up, which can crush us. And you know, python.The big snake will wrap itself around the person and crush them.
这个情况就像一条蛇，它有时候会突然把你给咬一下。
If you go in the forest, there may be big snake like that, and they can just very quickly wrap around you and devour you, swallow you.
就像你去森林里面，就经常会遇到这种情况。一条蛇会突然之间追着你，赶着你，要咬你一口。
Yeah, and if they bite us, then we fall unconscious due to the poison, and we don't know what's going on. So conditioned life is like that, being bitten by a snake. You don't see what's going on in life.
如果我们被这个蛇给咬了一口之后，我们会立刻的昏倒，而失去知觉，中了毒一样。我们的这个物质生活呢，也就像这样，我们在这个物质生活中也是失去了知觉的一种状况。
Material life means four things: eating, sleeping, mating, defending.
物质生活主要有四件事情：吃、睡、防卫和交配。
So the sleep is very, very serious thing. We need to get some sleep. We don't want to sleep too much. Don't sleep too little.
睡觉是一个很重要的事情。我们既不能睡得太多，也不能睡得太少。
Just like Prabhupada only used to sleep 2 hours a night.
就像圣帕帕德，他经常只是睡两个小时。
And the Goswamis also, they conquered over eating and sleeping.
这些 Goswami 们也是这样，他们也只睡差不多不到两个小时。他们超越了，克服了。吃饭和睡觉。
So we should be careful not to become a victim of too much sleep.
我们应该小心，不应该太多的去睡眠。
So in the forest also, there's different creatures which bite us, envious creatures like snakes and other things.
在这个森林里面还会有其他的一些动物可能会咬伤我们，比如是像蛇这样的类似的生物。
Just like in material life, we may have enemies, and they may give us so many troubles, just like these creatures which bite us.
就像在这个物质生活中，我们也有很多的敌人，他们就像这些蛇一样，有些时候会咬我们。
And we become so much in anxiety.That we cannot sleep properly at night.
我们会非常的焦虑，而且晚上也容易睡不着。
It becomes very unhappy, and we lose all our intelligence.
我们也会不快乐，失去我们的智慧。
We become just like a blind man who has fallen in the well.
就像一个盲人落入到黑井之中。
Sometimes also, conditioned soul is attracted to find more happiness. He looks to steal someone else's property.
有些时候受限制的这些灵魂也会被一些快乐所吸引。他就盯着别人的这个钱财。
Sometimes he may even take another man's wife or some other man's girlfriend or like this somebody else's woman.For his own sexual pleasure.
有些时候他也想着别人的妻子，别人的这些女人，想跟他们过一些非法的性生活。
And then the woman's husband comes, or the woman's father comes, and he's very angry that you've had a relationship with this girl illicitly, and they really get angry at you.
当这个女人的丈夫或者她的监护人，比如说她的父亲知道了这个事情，她会非常的生气。你既然和我的女人或者女儿发生了这种关系，她非常的生气。
And they may even put you into jail. You get accused of rape.
她甚至可能会把你拖到监狱里面去。
Yeah, that you raped the girl, you had illicit sex with the girl, you go to court and they put you in jail.
因为你犯了这种强奸罪，你得坐牢。
So the conditioned soul, he'll do all these things just trying to enjoy, trying to find pleasure in material life.
这些受条件限制的灵魂，他之所以做这些事情，他只是想在这个物质世界之中寻找一些快乐而已。
Sometimes people steal another person's motorbike or a motor car, and then when they get caught, then they're put into jail for that.
有些时候，人们去偷别人的摩托车啊、汽车啊，然后呢就被警察抓到了，去到了监狱。
So people do all of these things, they perform all this stealing and illicit connections, they're doing all this for their sense gratification.
人们去偷盗只是为了他自己的感官享乐而已。
And the same way with meat eating and intoxication, people do it to get more sense gratification.
同样的，吃肉也好，非法的性生活等等这些罪恶活动也好，他只是为了感官享乐而已。
And then when he wants women, he has to have money, so he will steal money and borrow money, take money from others, and then use it to attract women.
因为要有女人，就想要有女人，就必须得要钱，所以他要么就是找别人借钱，要么就是偷钱。
So in this way, just for their sexual pleasure, for their sense gratification, they go through so much suffering, so many embarrassing situations, and they get so many problems.
所以为了他的感官享乐，他会做很多尴尬的事情，很多会遭受痛苦的事情。
So we should be careful to control the senses.Not to become a slave of the senses.
所以我们应该很小心地控制自己的感官，不要成为感官的奴隶。
The more we're attracted and indulging in sex, the more miseries come in our life.
我们越沉溺于这种性生活，我们的物质现实的生活会有越来越多。
So we should be very careful how to use this human form of life and not waste it for sense gratification.
因此我们应该很小心地运用我们的这个人体生命，如人体生命，运用我们的人体生命，不要浪费我们的人体生命。
Human life is meant for self-realization. It's not meant for just sense gratification.
人体生命是用来灵性的自我觉悟的，而不是用来感官享乐的。
That is like a miser. One who has money, doesn't spend it, is a miser.
这被称为一个吝啬鬼。如果一个人老是有钱，但是他不愿意去花钱的话，这个人就被称为吝啬鬼。
And the same way, one who has a human form of life and doesn't use it for self-realization, then he's a miser.
同样的道理，如果一个人他拥有这个人体生命，而不是用来灵性的觉悟的话，他也被称为一个吝啬鬼。
Yeah, the pleasure of sense gratification is there even for the pigs which eat stool.
因为感官享乐到处都有，即便是一个猪，它也有感官享乐。
So we should be very careful to avoid these kind of activities.As much as possible, everything must be done according to scripture.
所以我们应该很小心地去从事这些活动。我们所做的这些活动应该遵循这个经典的这个教导。
There is no harm in having a relationship with the wife and enjoying sex life to produce Krishna conscious children. That is a religious activity.
如果你和你的妻子生育一个有 Krishna 知觉的小孩，这是没有伤害的，而且这是一个符合宗教原则行为的活动。
And the same way, when we take food and offer it to Krishna and take prasadam, that is devotional service, very pleasing to Krishna.
如果我们去吃供奉过给 Krishna 的这种 prasadam。这也是一个很好的活动，这是一种奉爱服务，甚至能够取悦 Krishna。
So whatever we do, try to do it in Krishna consciousness.
无论我们做什么，应该带着 Krishna 知觉去做。
But people are so blind, they're so ignorant, they have no thought about Krishna. They only think about their body and their senses.
人们非常的盲目，以至于他们根本就没有想到 Krishna， 他们想到的只是他的感官而已。
So then, people are always anxious to get money, and they will do all kinds of things to get money. They will cheat and steal from other people just to get money.
人们总是想去获得很多的这个钱。他要么他总想着从别人那里，甚至想着从别人那里偷钱。
And then another person comes to that person who cheated and stole the money. Another person comes to him and he cheats him and takes the money.
人们通过欺骗和偷取得到的钱，然后另外又有一个人跑到他的面前来，把通过欺骗和偷又把他的钱给夺去了。
And then another person comes to him and he takes away the money from him.
又来了一个人，然后把他的钱给欺骗和拿走了。
So it's the nature of Lakshmi. It is Chanchala. It does not stay in one place.
这就是幸运女神这个钱的这个本性。它是掺掺了，不稳定的。
Comes from one hand, goes to another, somebody else's hand. Out of one hand, person's hand, into another person's hand, then into another person's hand.
总是从一个人的手里到另外一个人手里，然后到另外一个人的手里。
Actually, all the wealth belongs to Krishna. It's all his property.
事实上，所有的钱都属于 Krishna。都是 Krishna 的财富。
Wealth is actually Lakshmi, and she is the property of Krishna.
钱财是 Lakshmi, 她是 Krishna 的财产。
So Lakshmi, she cannot stay in one place, but at the same time, she is very chaste. She will never stay far away from her husband.
Lakshmi 一方面她是 Chanchala, 不会在一个地方停留。另外一个方面，她是非常贞洁的，她永远跟她的爱人 Krishna 在一起。
She's always peaceful when she's with Lord Narayan. Lord Narayan is the husband of Lakshmi.
Narayan 呢是 Lakshmi 的丈夫，她在 Narayan 的面前总是非常的平和。
So, there's many people who are like Ravan. Ravan, he tried to take away Mother Sita, who is the goddess of fortune. He tried to take her away from Lord Ram.
很多人就像 Ramana 那样，他想把这个西塔从 Rama 的身边给夺走。
So,
西塔就是 Rama 的妻子。
Ravan's whole kingdom was completely destroyed, and Mother Sita was recovered and brought back to Lord Ram.
Ramana 整个的国王全部被毁掉了，然后西塔母亲回到了 Rama 的身边。
So foolish people.They collect money and steal from others, but they cannot keep it.
愚蠢的人，他从别人那里偷取了钱财或欺骗的钱财，保持在自己，但是呢，他根本就保存不了长久。
So the best way to keep Lakshmi is to keep her with Lord Narayan.
最好的把钱存起来的方法是让钱跟 Narayana 在一起。
So just like devotees, we collect money, but the money belongs to Radha and Krishna.
就像奉献者一样，我们也收集钱，但是呢，这个钱属于 Radha 和 Krishna.
Radha and Krishna is the same as Lakshmi Narayan.
Radha 和 Krishna 事实上就是 Lakshmi 和 Narayana.
And when we use the money for the service of Lakshmi Narayan,Then we live very nicely, very happily, very peacefully, very opulently.
当我们把钱用于服务于 Lakshmi Narayana, 我们会过着非常平和、快乐和富裕的生活。
But if we try to live like Ravan, then we will get a lot of problems.
但是如果我们像 Ravana 一样活动，我们会遭受很多的麻烦。
And Krishna will come as death and take everything away.
Krishna 会以死亡的形式带走一切。
So, the conditioned soul is not able to protect himself from the miseries of material life.
这个受条件限制的灵魂无法让自己不受这个物质痛苦的影响。
So he feels always very unhappy and he's lamenting about all the suffering which he's going through.
他在这种经历的各种痛苦的过程中，总是会产生各种悲伤和难受的情绪。
The different miseries like the climatic conditions, the heat and the cold.
比如说这种天气和气候产生的这种痛苦，严寒、酷暑等等这样的情况。
Miseries from other people.
第二种痛苦是来自于其他生物体造成的痛苦。
Just like here in Mayapur last night, for the last few nights, there's people playing music, and they play music the whole night, very loud, and it's very horrible, terrible music.
就像在这里的马亚普，在最近这几天，当地的这些人呢，晚上发出了很大噪音去玩这个音乐，非常非常的大的这种噪音。
And they do this every night. They start playing now. They started playing 2 days ago. They played all the way up to February, every night, for the whole night.
嗯，他们从二月份其实就已经开始了，每天晚上就经常玩这个很大噪音的音乐。
So this is material life. You suffer due to other living entities.
这就是物质世界的这种情况。你总是被因他人而遭受很多的痛苦。
And you suffer from the body as well, miseries of the body and the mind.
有些时候我们也会还有一种痛苦是来自于心意和躯体的痛苦。
Just like Bhaktivikas Swami just now, he's got a slip disc, so he cannot sit for very long. He has to lay down on his back all the time.
就像 Bhaktivikas Swami, 他因为有一些身体上的问题，他不能坐在这个凳子上太长时间，所以他总是得躺着。
These material bodies, they're just made to give trouble.
这种物质的躯体给我们带来的总是麻烦。
To get pleasure is so difficult, but to get suffering and pain in the body is very easy.
要得到一点快乐是非常不容易的，但是呢，要使这个物质躯体痛苦是非常容易的。
So when we come to deal with money, sometimes somebody cheats us, and it will be just a small amount, but because they cheated us.But then we become enemies. We hate them forever.
人和人之间有些时候会有一些交易，但是呢，即便是一丁点的这种不公平或者说欺诈，人和人之间就会变成敌人。
Material life means people have that tendency to cheat each other. We actually see this even with devotees. Some devotees are really they cheat. They tell lies. They cheat.
物质世界的这个人和人之间总是有这种欺骗的这种倾向，我们会发现，即便是有时候在奉献者这个里面，也会有这种欺骗他人的情况存在。他们总是有这种倾向，想去欺骗别人。
Just like there were two devotees, they were doing business together, and one devotee cheated the other devotee, and then the devotee said to him, "Why are you so attached? You're a devotee."
就像两个奉献者，一个奉献者欺骗了另外一个奉献者，然后一个奉献者说，sorry, Gurudev, why you attached?
Yeah, you're a devotee. Why you so attached? You shouldn't be attached.
所以一个奉献者就跟这个奉献者说，你为什么那么的依附呢
？The one devotee took all the money of the other devotee, and the devotee is telling him, why don't be attached?
一个奉献者把另外一个奉献者的钱全部给骗走了，然后这个奉献者还大摇大摆地说：“你为什么要那么依附这些钱呢
？”Now this is, you know, sometimes devotees are like this.
所以有些时候奉献者就像这种情况。
So sometimes even somebody is a philosopher, they speak a lot of philosophy, but he also cheats. He doesn't speak the truth.
就像一些哲学家，他即便口里说着这些哲学，他也会像一个骗子一样去行事。
We see scientists also; they present so many things which are not true. They say this is science, but they know it's not true.
有些科学家也是骗子，他们即便好像说跟别人说哦，这是科学的，但是这些东西却又不能够实现。所以他们经常也是说一些骗人的话。
Just like they say, people went to the moon, but nobody went again. They say they went to the moon, but nobody went again. It's all lying and cheating.
他说我们去过月球，但是我们发现他们再也没有去过月球，实际上他们是欺骗。
So there's so many defects in material life. We have these terrible defects, how we cheat with each other and try to take advantage of each other. We have to learn to overcome these tendencies and transcend material nature by devotional service.
We all have these basic deficiencies.而超越这些缺陷，我们必须通过做奉爱服务的方式来超越这个四项人类的基本缺陷。
And then we can be happy in this life and in the next life.
这样我们才能够变得快乐，在这一世以及在下一世。
But in material life, it's all so many difficulties. There's just one problem after another.
但是在这个物质世界，总是有各种各样的麻烦和困难，一个接着一个的。
Just the one poet, one Indian poet, he said, the happiness in material life is like the drop of water in the desert.
在印度有一句谚语，在这个物质世界的快乐就像沙漠中的一滴水一样。
When you're in the desert.And you'd give him one drop of water. So this is the so this happiness of material life.
当我们在这个沙漠里的时候，人们给你一滴水，而这一滴水就像我们在这个物质世界中获得的快乐一样。
People claim that they're scientists. They claim they're philosophers or politicians, but they're all rascals, cheaters.
有一些人声称自己是科学家、哲学家，或者说什么什么家，但是他们只是一群无赖。
In Bhagavad Gita, Krishna calls them mudhas or donkeys or naradamas, the lowest of men.
在《博伽梵歌》中 ，Krishna 把这群人称为 mudhas, naradamas, 人类中最低贱的人。
They have the human form of life, but.They don't use it for Krishna consciousness.
他们有这个人体的生命，但是他们没有用这个人体生命用于 Krishna 知觉。
So these scientists and other people, they are also the same way. They don't have real knowledge. They simply have some material education.
这些科学家，即便是这些科学家，他们事实上并没有真正的知识。他们有的只是物质上的一些教育而已。
They don't know how to get free from birth and death.
他们不知道从这个生死之中获得解脱的方法。
But they're trying to get happiness here in this material world from their material body.
但是他们想在这个物质世界的物质躯体之中，想在这个里面获得快乐。
And ultimately, they just have envy for Krishna.They are envious of Krishna, and so they're demons.
通常情况下，他们还会嫉妒至尊、人格守神、嫉妒 Krishna. 他们实际上是恶魔。
And they'll enter into the lowest species of life.
这样他们就会投身到这种最低的种族之中。
So in conditioned life, also we become very attracted. The illusion ofMaterial life is very strong. When we're with the opposite sex, when you're with the girlfriend or the wife, and you become eager to embrace, to be embraced by the woman, the man wants to be embraced by the woman, or the woman wants to be embraced by the man.
在这个物质世界之中，我们经常受异性的吸引。男的呢，想被他的妻子或者女人拥抱。女人想被她的丈夫或者她的男朋友给拥抱。
So that time the attachment becomes very strong, and man's thinking about how to provide, how to make nice arrangements for the care for the woman.
在那一刻，他们之间的依附是非常强大的。于是这个男的他就会想，我怎么样为我的女方。 为我的女友或者我的妻子提供一个很好的住所或一个好的舒适的环境呢？
And he wants to make a nice home so that they can live together and have their children, and they will meet together and enjoy each other's company.
他就想着我怎么样为我的妻子有一个家庭，然后呢，在这个家庭他们过得舒适，每天晚上可以享受彼此的陪伴。
So in this way he loses Krishna consciousness.
但是呢，他却丧失了 Krishna 知觉。
Just a minute, let me put the light on. So there's the attachment with the wife or with the girlfriend is very powerful, and we completely forget about the goal of life, that the spiritual purpose of life.
男女双方的这种吸引依附是非常非常强大和深的，如此他们就甚至呢会让一个人失去忘记他的人生的目标。
Being embraced with the arms wrapping around the body of the other person, the man and the woman, it's just like creepers in the forest. They have these creepers, long creepers which grow, and so you become entangled with these creepers.
我们喜欢美女的拥抱，但是呢，这个美女美丽的胳膊的这个拥抱啊，就像一个蔓藤一样，长的这个蔓藤一样，把你紧紧地束缚在这个物质世界的情况。
So this is material existence. This is how we become caught in material life, birth after birth.
这就是物质世界存在的这种实际情况。我们一世一世的生在这种生死的轮回之中，被捆绑住。
So Lord Krishna has a weapon, which is the disc, the Sudarshan Chakra, and this is
Krishna.
This is like the wheel of time.
Krishna 有他的武器叫神，是一个神碟，他的名字是 Sudarshan Chakra, 而这个神碟被称为时间的飞轮。
And it expands from the beginning of the atoms up to the time of Brahma's death.
从原子一直扩展到 Brahma 死亡的时刻。
And it controls all the activities.
控制着一切的活动。
It's always revolving.
它总是在旋转着。
And it's using up the life of all the living entities from Brahma down to the tiniest insect.
这神碟环绕并消耗着所有生物的生命，上至 Brahma, 下至微不足道的小草。
Nobody can stop this wheel of time.
没有人可以停下这个时间的飞轮。
And under this influence of time, our body is changing from childhood to youth and then to old age.
在这个飞轮旋转的时候，人们经历婴儿、童年、青年。
So this wheel is actually the weapon of Krishna.
这个飞轮实际上是至尊人格守神 Krishna 的武器。
So sometimes the conditioned soul, because in material life they're very afraid of death, so they want to worship someone who can save them from the danger of death.
有些时候受条件限制的灵魂他非常恐惧这个死亡，于是呢在那个快要死的时候他开始崇拜一些人，好让这个人来帮助自己。
But the conditioned soul is so stupid, he will not worship Krishna, whose weapon is this time factor.
但是这个人呢又非常的愚蠢，他根本没有崇拜 Krishna, 事实上 Krishna 是这个时间武器的拥有者。
Instead, he will surrender himself to some unauthorized god.
而取而代之的，他去崇拜一些 没有被经典认可的非权威的这些神。
So these gods which they surrender to, they're just like vultures or even crows.
这些所谓的神就好像飞鹰和秃鹫一样。
There's nothing about them in the scriptures.
我们在经典中找不到任何关于他们的描述。
So death is just like the attack of a lion.
死亡就像一个攻，像一个狮子的攻击一样。
And so a vulture or a crow cannot save us from the attack of a lion.
这些飞鹰、秃鹫、乌鸦根本无法救，从这个狮子的攻击之中拯救我们。
If we surrender to these kind of gods, they cannot save us from death.
如果我们臣服于这些神，他们根本不能帮助我们，拯救我们从死亡之中，拯救我们。
But if we surrender to Krishna, then we can cross beyond birth and death.
但是如果我们臣服 Krishna, 我们可以从这个生死之中解脱出来。
So we're trying to bring people back to Krishna consciousness, but people are so demonic, they're so atheistic, that they don't want to be Krishna conscious.
我们想把人带到 Krishna 知觉，但是呢，很多人他是无神论，而且他们不想回到这个 Krishna 知觉。
So we are always trying to think how to save them from being cheated by all of these so-called gods and the so-called bluffers in the material world.
所以我们要想的是怎么样去拯救这些人，他们被这些假瑜伽师、假神、假的这些化身被这些人所欺骗。我们想的是我们怎么样去拯救他们。
There are so many incarnations who are bogus and different false yogis and swamis. They don't believe in the Supreme Lord. They're all actually atheists.
有很多假的化身、假死瓦米、假的瑜伽师，他们实际上是非人，是无神论者。
They're actually fallen souls, and they're cheated. They've been cheated because they don't know the real path.
他们实际上是一些堕落的灵魂，而且他们还在欺骗。
And if somebody goes to them, then they also get cheated. They will take them on the boat on the wrong path.
如果有人去找他们的话，他们也会得到气，他们也会被骗，而走上一个错误的道路。
So when somebody gets cheated, then somehow he may somehow find the real path. He may come to Krishna consciousness, and they teach him about worshipping Krishna.
当人受到这样的欺骗的时候，有时候会脱避于伟达，会回到真正的这个道路上面。
So he comes to Krishna consciousness, but still he can't keep the principles, and they can't follow strictly, and they have to give up.
他们虽然回到了这个真正的道路上面，但是呢，他们又无法追随这个原则，保持这个原则，然后又再一次堕落了。
And in this way, then they go back to their old habits of sinful activities.
然后呢，他们又重回自己的老路，开始了一些以前的罪恶活动的行为。
And they become very active again. They're very eager to have illicit sex, just like monkeys who have a lot of illicit sex. These people have mentality like monkeys.So these people who are enlivened by sex, they are actually like descendants of the monkeys.
这些人堕落了之后呢，他们又回到以前的这些坏习惯。他们的这个行，有些时候他们又回到这种，对这种非法性生活又堕落到其中。而这些人呢，就像猴子一样，因为性对猴子非常重要。这些对性乐此不疲的人，他们可谓是猴子的后代。
So, this is the position of people in material life who are absorbed in the bodily concept.
这些就是那些有躯体化概念的物质世界的这些人所呈现出来的这种本性的情况。
Prabhupada explains that when we come to the human form of life from sattva, if we come through the, when we come to the human form from the quality of sattva gun, that means we were cows in the last incarnate, last life.
深帕帕德说，在达到人体生命之前所经历的最后一个动物，通常是所经历的最后一个动物的躯体是奶牛。
And those who come in the mode of passion, then they're like they were animals in their last life.
而那些通过激情属性达到人体生命所经历的一个之前的一个动物躯体是狮子。
And those who come through the quality of ignorance, they were monkeys in their last life.
而通过愚昧属性所达到的人体生命之前的这个躯体，它是猴子，只是通过善良属性是牛啊，前面说错了。
So people like Darwin, who is the anthropologist, he had the theory about evolution. He's understood to be a descendant of the monkeys.
那些经历的猴子种族的人被称为达尔文之流的现代人类学家，则被称为是猴子的后代。
So those who are simply interested in sex are not—they're just like monkeys.
所以那些对性生活非常感兴趣的人，他们就像猴子一样。
And sometimes people in old age, they still want to have sex, but their bodies are too old, so they take the sex organ from the monkey and they put it in the man, so the old man can still have sex.
有一些老人，他无法享受性生活，在他老的时候，他甚至把猴子的这个性腺移植到人体的身上，甚至呢，然后让自己享受这种性的快乐。
So many monkeys in India were caught and they sent them to Europe so that they could take the sex glands from the monkeys to give to the old men who still wanted to have sex.
印度有很多的猴子被人这个抓起来，然后呢运送到欧洲去，这样他们的这个猴子的性的腺就更换到老年那些欧洲的老年人的身上。
So this is the nature of material world. You can see, so we use technology, so much advanced technology, to do just so that we can have more eating, sleeping, mating, and defending.
这就是物质世界的本性。我们虽然有很先进的这种高科技的知识和技术，但是呢，我们运用这些知识技术，只是为了提高我们的吃睡防卫和交配而已。
Even in the higher planets, the demigods, they are also very attached to sex pleasure.
即便是在高等的星球，这些天堂星球，他们也沉迷于性的生活。
The material life is based on these things. People can't live without it.
物质生活就基于这些活动而存在，人们无法不从事这些活动。
Okay, so we will stop here today.
好，我们今天先讲到这儿。
Are there any questions?
Yes. Wait a moment. The first question from the Janaka Prabhu. 顶拜 Gurudev 的莲花组，顶拜翻译和奉献者们，请问 Gurudev， 在灵性世界没有钱，没有钱吗？如果没有钱，但是有纳什米在那里，它不代表钱。如果也有灵性世界的钱，纳什米是不是还代表着钱呢？在物质世界里，纳什米代表着钱，但在远古时代是以物换物，那个时候还没有钱的概念，钱是人类创造出来的概念。为什么要把这种钱的东西称作是纳什米至尊主的妻子呢？Okay, obeisances to Gurudev's lotus feet, obeisances to translator and the devotees. I want to ask Gurudev, in the spiritual world, whether they have the money. If they have money, but the Lakshmi said, the Lakshmi didn't represent the money. But if in the spiritual world also have money, Lakshmi, whether represent the money in the material world, even though the Lakshmi represent the money, but in the ancient times, people use the things to change the things. They don't have the conception of the money. Money is the human beings created. Money is a conception of conception by the humans. So why we use the money to represent the spiritual the Lord's wife Lakshmi?
Okay, so there's no money in the spiritual world. Yeah, money is only here in the material world, and we see the nature of the money. It's paper money, it's useless, no value. It used to be that people had the money was valuable things, that the coins were valuable, that there were gold coins and silver coins, and the coins had actual value. But today you have just pieces of paper which have no value.
钱实际上应该代表的是有价值的物质。 比如说我们以前用的这种金币、银币，它们是真正有价值的。但是呢，我们现在手上的这些现钞、钞票，实际上只是一些纸而已，没有真正的价值。In
the spiritual world, there's no scarcity of anything. Everything is provided, everything for everyone's need. And everyone has also yoga powers, they all have yoga siddhis. So if they want anything, they can get it without money.
在灵性世界没有这些东西，人们都有这种瑜伽的力量。如果人们需要一些东西的话，他通过这种瑜伽的力量马上就可以得到，他不需要这个所谓的现在的这些钱。If
you have yoga siddhis, you can bring things from far away, whatever you want. You can just bring it immediately in your hand.
如果你有瑜伽的这种完美的话，你可以从很远的地方拿到一个东西，很远就可以得到。
Then you have things like Kalpa Briksha trees. They fulfill all desires. Everything you want can come from the tree.
比如说还有这个 Kalpa Briksha tree 这个树，它是如愿树，能够满足所有的愿望。
And then they have Kamadhenu cows. They give everything you want.
还有这个 Kamadhenu 这个奶牛，它可以满足你所有想要的一切。
Money is useless thing.
钱是没有用的东西。
So it's only here in this material world, on this planet here, we find money.
只是在这个物质世界，我们才有这个钱，才用这个钱。
So we should understand nature of the spiritual world, that there's no scarcity, nothing lacking, everything is provided.
所以我们也了解物质世界的本性，而在灵性世界，一切都是全然的满足的，没有缺少。And
everything is provided here, but the problem is, there's not enough for everyone's greed. There's enough for our need, not enough for our greed.
实际上，在这个物质世界，所有的一切也都被提供着，一切都有，只是呢，它。 能够满足我们所有的需要，但是并不能满足我们的贪呢。Okay,
any other question?
Next question from the Chandravani David Darcy. 顶拜孤乳甜美的莲花组顶拜奉献者们，请教孤乳，富裕生活怎么去理解，同时怎么去呈现给他人。 吸引他人进入到Krishna知觉呢? So obeisance to Guru Maharaj's lotus feet, obeisance to devotees. I want to ask, how to understand the wealthy life, and how to present this kind of life, and attract others to come into the Krishna consciousness.
Well, the real wealth is in Krishna consciousness. If you want to show wealth, then show Krishna conscious wealth.
真正的富裕实际上是Krishna知觉。 如果你想呈现真正的富裕，那就呈现Krishna知觉。
Sometimes we also say real wealth is in the land and the cows.
有些时候我们也说真正的富裕是你有土地和奶牛。
If you have land, you can grow lots of food and grains, and if you have cows, then you get the most important thing, milk.
如果你有土地，你可以种植五谷和蔬菜。如果你有奶牛，你可以生产出最重要的东西——牛奶。So
wealth is in the nature's resources. What is provided by nature?
富裕实际上是这个本性，它被物质的这种本性所提供。Different
precious stones and silk. And cotton, this kind of cloths, not synthetic things, not plastic.
比如说我们看到了这个宝石、丝绸，而等等这些东西都是代表了这种富裕的这种本物质的本性，又是富裕的东西，而不是我们所生产的这些塑料袋。
So the wealth of the world is there also, and the human form of life is also a great wealth. We sometimes say time is the greatest wealth, because time cannot be bought back. 1 second lost of time cannot be bought back, and so it's more valuable than anything else. So the greatest wealth is time, so we should use every moment very carefully for the service of Krishna.
我们说人体生命也是宝贵的财富，我们也说这个时间也是宝贵的财富，花千金都买不回一刻的这个时间，我们无法让这个一刻往后面往前面倒退一点都无法实现，所以我们应该利用每一个片刻的时间发展我们的这个
People don't know how to make proper use of time.
人们不知道如何恰当的运用时间.
They waste their time in mundane activities.
人们浪费时间总是从事一些物质世俗的活动.
Watch television, go to movie shows, do all kinds of Sanskrit.
看电视，看这些电视剧等等的这些行为，总是用这些浪费时间在感官享乐上。Okay,
还有？目前还没看到，要等一下萨提玛的节目。Okay.
这个问题来自于A Mine，请问Guru，既然都是资深的奉献者夫妻，应该懂得摆正各自的角色，并和谐共同服务 Krishna。出现这种情况，是某一方没有把父爱瑜伽用在生活上吗？我可以这样理解吗？ So I want to ask the Guru, one moment. They are the senior devotees couples, so they should know what's the real role and how to get together to serve Krishna. In that condition, is someone not use the bhakti yoga, not apply the bhakti yoga in their life? Can I understand like that?
Oh, they don't apply bhakti yoga to.
I also a little confused about this question. I don't know what's the situation she faced. Sati Mataji, 您能简单的说一下吗？Okay, we change other question.
Yeah.
Okay, from the Chaitanya Charam Prabhu, Hare Krishna, Dimbai Gurudev. 刚才讲到奉献者之间存在欺骗，我们也看到很多地方奉献者因欺骗而产生很多纠纷。为什么修习 Krishna 之觉还有那么多的欺骗和纠纷？怎样避免
？Yeah.
So I want to ask Guru Maharaj.You mentioned that in the devotees also have some cheatings. I also see many cheatings during the in the devotees. So why these things happen in the Krishna consciousness, and how do you avoid these things?
Well, actually, this is not Krishna consciousness. When people cheat, when people lie and cheat, this is not Krishna consciousness.
实际上。当人们欺骗的时候，这不是 Krishna 之觉。
But sometimes Prabhupada explains, he said, sometimes, he said, because everyone's a cheater, and so he said, sometimes we do cheating in order to do some preaching.
嗯，圣帕帕德也解释呢，因为每一个人都是一个欺骗的这个人，有些时候我们用欺骗去做一些传教活动。
Because if we don't cheat, they're all cheaters, they're all cheating, and if we don't cheat, then we will get, you know, they will just simply take advantage of us. But we can only cheat for the sake of doing some service for Krishna, we cannot cheat for our sense gratification.
但是呢，我们欺骗只是为了 Krishna 知觉，去传播 Krishna 知觉。我们绝不能用欺骗用于自己的感官享乐。
But still, we should make a habit. We should not make a habit of cheating everywhere. We shouldn't make it a daily thing. But there may be some special situation where, in order to achieve something, we may have to cheat a little.
我们不能把欺骗用于任其他的这个方面，尤其是欺骗别人，为了获得一点点的 ，sorry, good day.
Yeah, we shouldn't make a habit of cheating every day.
我们不应该每天有这种欺骗的这种习惯存在。
But sometimes there may be some special situation where we may cheat.
只是在一些很特别的这种情况下，我们才去做一些欺骗。
Just like Lord Vamanadeva came to Bali Maharaj, and he said, "I just want 3 steps of land."
就像主 Vamanadeva 去到 Bali Maharaj, 他跟 Bali Maharaj 说，我只要3步的土地。
So, of course, he only took 3 steps of land, but.It was unexpected how he would take the 3 steps of land.
确实他只要3步的土地，但是对于他怎么样去拿的呢？他的这个方式又跟别人是不一样的。
And so like that, sometimes in order to preach Krishna consciousness.
所以有些时候我们欺骗是为了传播 Krishna 知觉。Okay, next question from the Harini. Dimbai Guru, Dimbai 翻译 Krishna, 哦，这是 Krishna Premi, Krishna Puri 问
Krishna Priya.
Krishna Priya.
Harini's mother.
我们这一生的智慧和聪明才智是否跟我们前世的出身和来路有关呢？为什么有的笨人还非常诚实，而聪明人反而诚实的很少？这些跟什么有关系呢？感恩 Guru 的回答。So, obeisance to Guru and the translators. Our life, the intelligence and the wisdom. What's this wisdom and the intelligence come is whether they come from the last, the previous life. Why some stupid person, they are very honest, and why some intelligent person, they are not very honest. What's the relationship? Thanks to Guru Maharaj.
Yeah. So, wisdom and intelligence, where does it come from?
Yeah, whether they come from the previous life or any other ways.
Well, in Bhagavad Gita, Lord Krishna says, from me comes, Krishna says, I am in the heart of everyone, from me comes knowledge, remembrance and forgetfulness.
这个佛家梵歌中 Krishna 说我处在每个人的心里记忆知识和遗忘智慧都是来自于我
So we have to consider in what way are they intelligent, in what way are they wise. Is it material wisdom or is it spiritual wisdom? Is it wisdom for their sense gratification or is it wisdom for Krishna's service?
所以我们应该去考虑和辨别他们的这种智慧和智商是从哪个方面去看的？他们是一种物质的这种智慧呢，还是一种灵性的这种智慧？
Some people may have very good material intelligence, they're very wise in terms of material things, but they have no spiritual vision.
有一些人他可能在物质上非常的聪明，非常的有智慧，但是呢，他只是用这些智慧夺取一些物质的东西，他并没有灵性的智慧和灵性的视域。
So this material qualification comes from their karma.
这种物质的这种资格和这种才能是来自于他的业报。
But spiritual qualification, that comes by the mercy of a devotee and by our devotional service.
而灵性的这种智慧是来自于灵性的资格或智慧是来自于他的奉献服务以及奉献者的仁慈。
Srila Prabhupada said he was never cheated with anything. People, you know, many people came to him for different business, there were so many things Prabhupada had to deal with to set up the society, but nobody could ever cheat him.
圣帕帕的说，他虽然在从事这个协会的各种的这种琐事、各种的事务，但是呢，没有人可以欺骗他。
Some people tried to cheat him, but they were not successful.
有一些人尝试着去欺骗圣帕帕的。
So somebody may be materially stupid, they may appear to be not intelligent, but they may be very honest. Well, that's a good qualification. That's a good quality.
有一些人看起来很笨，但是如果他诚实的话，这是一个很好的品质。
Of course, but because they're not very intelligent, you can't trust them very much, you can't give them a great responsibility.
但是呢，由于他智慧不足，我们又无法全部的相信他。So
they can only handle something very simple, very small, not very important thing.
对于这种虽然笨但是又很诚实的人，我们不能把很大的事情交给他，我们只能给他一些小的事情让他去做。
So this is also karma.
这也是一种业报。
Everyone are suffering and enjoying according to our past karma.
任何人遭受痛苦或者是享受快乐,
Somebody,
有一些都来自于他的业报。
In some ways it's a blessing. It's a blessing to be not to be very intelligent, not to have much wisdom. It's a blessing because people don't expect much from you.
有些时候没有智慧也是一种祝福，因为在这种情况下，人们会对你没有那么多的期待和要求。
But the more intelligent person, the more wisdom they have, then the more they're given responsibility and the more stress is on them.
那些很有智慧、很有头脑的人，他们越有头脑、越有智慧，他们要承担的责任也越多，他们的压力也会越大。
So better to be, this is why Jadbharat, you see Jadbharat, Jadbharat's going around everywhere like a deaf, like a stupid person. And that way he's free, he doesn't get troubled with material things.
就像 Jadbharat, 他到处去旅行，但是呢，他装扮的就像一个很笨的人一样，这样呢，他不会有各种的麻烦，也不会有各种的物质的这种骚扰。
And the gopis, they even said, Lord Brahma, he's stupid, he's stupid because he made these eyes which blink and we can't see Krishna. So Lord Brahma must be stupid.
These gopis, 木流姑娘们呢，也说 Brahma 是很愚蠢的，因为他创造的这个人的眼睛会眨，在眨的那一刻他看不见 Krishna.
So who is actually intelligent? It's a relative thing.
所以我们到底再这样再去看的话，我们到底去看谁是真正有智慧的呢？
People thought Sukadeva Goswami is some madman, some stupid person.
人们有的时候会认为 Sukadeva Goswami 甚至是一个疯子，是一个愚蠢的人。
But he was the most intelligent person.
但事实上他是真正有智慧的人，最有智慧的人。
Okay, any other question?
Okay, next question from Vedavati Maharaji, 顶拜 Guru 和翻译。现在我在管理每周有一节唱诵课，一个小时的课，请问 Guru, 我怎样利用好我这个时间去传播 Krishna 之觉呢？自己的力量太弱了。In my yoga studio, every week I have a kirtan class, 1 hour. So I want to ask Guru Maharaj, how to use this time properly to preach Krishna consciousness, because I feel very weak.
Well, you do kirtan. You advertised it as a kirtan program, so you get people to come, you get them all to chant. And you have kirtan, you chant the holy name.
你把他们组织起来，告诉广告说这是一个唱诵，然后呢，你让他们都去唱诵圣名。
If you're giving them the chanting of the holy name, that's the greatest service for them. Let them chant with you, get them also to chant with you.
如果你能够让他们唱诵这个圣名，让他们跟着你一起唱诵这是圣名，这是对于他们最好的这个服务。
Yeah.
这是他们最好的服务。
You train the people who come, train them also that they can also sometimes lead, and they can also sometimes play the instruments.
你有时候也可以训练他们，比如说让他们演奏一下乐器啊之类的。
有时候他们可以领唱，给他们机会。
有时候，对，有时候他们可以领唱，可以用乐器。
And then also encourage them to chant the holy name. I ask them if they have beads. Do they all have beads?
你也可以让他们去念诵，问一问他们有没有念珠。
And tell them that they can also chant on the beads.
告诉他们，他们也可以在这个念珠上去念诵。
Tell them, try to tell, encourage them that they can chant any time, any place.They can chant on their own.
告诉他们，你们可以在任何时间、任何地点去唱诵、念诵。
And they can also, they can have their own tune. They may like to compose their own tune, Chinese melody, whatever.
他们也可以编他们自己的这个曲调，中国的曲调，去唱诵这个 Hare Krishna。
anyway, encourage them to get some taste for this chanting.
无论如何，让他们获得一些唱诵，在这个唱诵上的一些品味。
Okay.
Okay. Next question from Kelly Lanita. Hare Krishna, 顶拜孤儿的莲花族。最近在群里看到好多奉献者发信息说，普鲁修塔玛月每天要给 Krishna 供奉一盏酥油灯，请问这个是必须的吗？请问孤儿，简单的普鲁修塔玛月的知识，感恩孤儿 day, Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna, obeisance to Guru Maharaj, Lotus Feet.Recently, I see many groups, WeChat groups, devotees message us in the Purushottama month. Every day, we should offer Krishna a lamp, a ghee lamp. I want to know whether this is necessary and this is we must do. I want to ask some basic knowledge of the Purushottama month. Thanks, Guru Maharaj.Hare Krishna.
Well, Srila Prabhupada never talked about Purushottama month because he understood all the devotees are already engaged in devotional service.
事实上呢，圣帕帕德从来没有说过，没有提及过这个普，特别提及过这个普舍塔玛月，因为他知道每一个奉献者都在从事奉献服务。
And every day, devotees are offering ghee lamp in the temple. We offer arti, we offer a ghee lamp. If you, when you do arti, you light a ghee lamp, offer a lamp.
因为每一天呢，如果我们做arti的时候，都会给神像供奉一盏灯，一盏酥油灯。
There's no rule that you have to offer a special, but for people who don't offer a lamp, then they can do it.
对于那些没有供灯的人，平常没有供灯的人，他可以去做一盏供灯。
So,
但是呢，对于奉献者来说，他实际上每天已经在做了。
So Purushottama month is for people who may not do much usually, is to encourage them to do more.
Purushottama 月是针对那些平常没有怎么做奉献服务的人，他应该做更多的奉献服务。
But.Most devotees, they're already chanting every day, they're already reading the books, they already offer. No, no, it's okay, you don't need to worry.
对于那些我们通常的这些奉献者而言，你每天都在念诵，每天都在阅读这个书籍，每天都在给神像做arti供灯，所以你不用太担心。
Okay.
Okay.I want to ask one question, Guruji. In the Srimad Bhagavan purport, one sentence said like this, unless one can overcome the defeat of the four defeat of the human being, so he never should receive the suggestions by others. So I want to ask whether the,devotees' suggestion is we should not listen.
Whether what?
The suggestions from the devotees, we should not listen to them all.
We shouldn't listen to the suggestions of devotees?
Because in the purport, Prabhupada said, unless one person overcome the human four
defects.
So he should not receive other suggestions. So my question is whether we should not receive the suggestions from the devotees.
Well, you have to consider about what suggestion they're offering and whether or not it's valid and whether there's.Relevant or valuable to you.
顾队，我先说一下这个中文哈。除非我问的问题是，除非一个人超越四项基本缺陷，否则不应该接受他人的建议。我问的问题是，是否奉献者的建议也不一定全听。刚才顾的回答是，我们要考虑这个人的建议是否是真正有价值的。
that we have to be able to know when to listen to people and when not to.
我们也要考虑时间，什么时候去听这个，什么时候该听，什么时候不该听。
And just like if there's gold in a dirty place, still we will take the gold.
就像这个黄金，如果人虽然它处在一个很脏的地方，但是它仍是黄金。
So you take knowledge may not be from the most reliable source, but if it's valuable knowledge, we should take it, we should accept it.
如果我们接受的这个知识虽然来自于不可靠的这个来源，但是呢，如果这个知识真正是很有价值的，我们应该去接受它。
Okay.
From next question from the Harini, 顶拜 Guru, 顶拜翻译，自己一个人在家唱诵或自己一个人在外面唱诵，算不算是 Kirtan? 感恩 Guru 的回答。When we chant in our home or when we chant outside alone, whether this kind of situation Kirtan is Kirtan or not? Then Guru.
Yeah, Kirtan means...loud, you know, it's you're not just chanting to yourself, but you're chanting other people can hear. Then that's kirtan.
大声的唱诵，能够让别人听到的这个唱诵就是 kirtan.
Whether you're at home or whether you're outside, it's kirtan.
在这种情况下的唱诵，无论你是在家里的还是在外面的，都是 kirtan.
Kirtan is a Yuga Dharma. Lord Chaitanya came to encourage everyone to do more Kirtan.
Kirtan 呢是年代的大法 ,Yuga Dharma. 主 Chaitanya 来到这个年代鼓励大家去 Kirtan.
So, we want to encourage people to do more Kirtan. Chant in the home and chant outside as well, if you can. Very nice.
我们鼓励所有人去 Kirtan, 无论是在家里面还是在外面都是非常好的。
Okay, any other question? 还有问题？
还有问题吗？三天八的机。
没有问题了。
Maybe
that, 上面那个 that question. 阿米的那个问题也没有说清 没有说清楚是想问什么。
Amy.
Okay.
Amy 的问题。
对他没有说得很清楚。
OK, 我可以跟他联系。
OK,
所以我们今天到这儿。
好
好的，
谢谢姑姑，
谢谢
顶拜姑姑，
谢谢您，谢谢萨提，舍勒普布帕基，
在
，Go back to Vrindaki,
在
，Go Premanandi。